Hi, this is Fran with littlewindows.com. In this video, I'll show you lots of ways to personalize your resin pieces with words, names, and initials. These are the techniques I'll be sharing. Here's an example of a project I made, layering type on a digital photo using Photoshop. To do that, you'll open a new file, bring in your image, and add type, whatever size, shape, font, and color you'd like. Then make sure to print on Little Windows special photo paper because it's the best you'll find for working with resin. In this example, I've added type to our vacation photos and printed on our clear photo film. And these become beautiful sun catchers. If you're not comfortable with Photoshop or you want to create some more dimension, you can copy your type onto our clear photo film. This is similar to an overhead transparency, but it's very high resolution, made for photography, and it will not bleed or run in your resin. This paper is available at little-windows.com, and it can run through any inkjet printer. This is the sheet that we use to create these pieces. To make these pieces, we used the 2-inch circle from our large mold set and poured a thin layer of resin with some bits and pieces of resin color film and dichroish films to give it a nice sparkly background. When this is set, you will pop it out of the mold and you have a slight dip in the center. You then cut out your type, put a small amount of resin, and when it's set up, they turn out like this. You can use our spring drill to easily create a hole for the jump rings. On these projects, I used the same technique, printing the type on clear photo film, and then layering it with my photos in a mold. In this case, I used one of the cavities of our silicone cabochons mold. This project used the doming technique. I domed the first side, let that set, applied dichroish film to the back of that photograph and layered on clear photo film with type. Here's another pretty piece we made in our cabochons mold. Framing our photograph with a metal finding and then adding the copy to the back. One of my favorite techniques is using wire to create words and letters. And layering those in the resin. You can add names, initials, or words. I have two different gauges of wire here. One is thicker and one is thinner. If you're doing a single letter and you want it to show up nicely, you might want to pick some thicker or lower gauge wire. If you'd like something very small and delicate, you'll want to go with one of the thinner wires. I'm going to make a few examples today. These two on the doming tray, this piece in one of our custom bezel shapes, and then a larger ornament. We always print our photos onto Little Windows special photo paper. It's waterproof and it won't bleed or run in the resin. We'll start by resizing and cropping our photos using the Little Windows photo cropping software. This will make a perfect fit for our medium molds or our custom bezel shapes. Or you can dome these pieces. You can also resize your photos using Photoshop, Microsoft Word, or Google Docs. Click the link below for a how-to guide. For this piece, I'm going to use our large oval mold to make a keepsake wedding ornament. So I've already poured a very thin layer of Little Windows Brilliant Resin with a little bit of silver glitter mixed in, and that creates the base for this piece. It's going to be detail outlined similar to these pieces. I'll use the cropping template that comes with the large mold set. Just place that over my photograph and trace around the section that I'm going to crop. I'm going to cut away the white behind the couple and then let this bottom portion hug the bottom of the mold. Cut out just inside the line. Now let's make the wire shapes. For this one, I just want the initial M. What I like to do is first draw the letters or words out on a piece of paper. So keep drawing your letters that you'd like to form until you get a shape that you really like that's going to fit your project. I really like this one. Cut a piece of wire longer than you need, and then you can start to shape the wire. And just hold this down while you work the wire around to follow the line that you've drawn. For the thicker wire, you may need some pliers to shape it, especially on the tight little curves. When you're working with colored wire, just be gentle with your pliers so that you don't scrape off that colorful coating. For the loops, you might want to pinch them tighter. Check it against your piece to make sure it fits nicely. And then with the ends, you can decide if you want them to curl or just end at the side or turn into another shape. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and put this piece into my bezel and see how that works. For this one, I'm going to create a wire that spells a name and makes a bale. So I'm tracing around my shape. Let's start with the name. So this will all be formed out of a single piece of wire. Snip off the ends now so it's a little easier to work with. And you're going to finish shaping your piece. You need to make sure your wire is flat so that when you embed it in the resin, there's nothing poking out. You'll want to pinch some of these shapes to make them a little more defined. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's meant to be somewhat whimsical. I'll snip that off. For each piece, you'll need to decide whether to use a thicker or thinner wire and how much detail you'd like to put into it. Part of it depends on what you want to say, because you can see you can get very, very, very small. In this case, the heavier wire is going to show up a little better. The thicker the wire you use, the more you're going to have to work to get the letter shapes the way you want them. So be a little flexible. It may take a couple of times to get it exactly the way you want. This is our kitty Tai Lu. And I want her name to go right across the bottom here. So, start T. I'm going to make it pretty small. L. U. And then I'll use the tail here to come over and cross the T. Then what you can do is dot the I later with either a flat back rhinestone or another small piece of wire. I put a little resin in the bottom of my bezel and then place my photograph in there. And now these are both ready to pour the next layer of resin. When you're working in a mold, you want to make sure to add your resin first and then slide in any photos or flat pieces that you have. That way you won't get air pockets trapped underneath. And then we can add our wire. You can use your mixing wand to position this just where you want it to be. We'll come back and check in 10 minutes to pop any stubborn bubbles. When you're working on domed pieces without a border, you'll want to let the resin thicken up a while before you insert your wire. So we're going to let these set for about 30 minutes. You can also use tweezers to position your wire. If you have bubbles in your project that are stuck on the surface of the photo paper, just use the tip of your mixing wand to gently lift those up. Once the bubbles are on the top of the resin, you can simply touch your mixing wand to the surface to lift them off. We do have some bubbles in the cast piece too, so again, place your mixing wand and lift those right out. I'm going to check this resin to see how thick. All right, this is thickening up nicely, but I want it to get a little thicker so that when I put the wire in, it's not going to push the resin over the edge. We've let this resin set for about 30 minutes, so it's nice and thick. And now we're ready to insert the wire. You can just lay that on top and let it sink into the resin. Another way to add letters, names, or words to your resin projects is with stickers. You can use all kinds of different stickers, but I really like these glitter ones. They show up really beautifully in the resin. Let me show you some projects we've made with this technique. In these projects, we've started with some pieces of resin color film, put them in a thin layer of resin on the bottom, and then added the stickers on top. You can do a single layer, or you can do multiple layers to create dimension, but you want to make sure that you finish these with a layer of resin to protect the stickers. Very simple, but a beautiful way to make a personalized piece. This piece was made the same way, but uses one of our bezels. In here, we cut a circle out of the red resin color film, and then we layered the sticker on top, coating it with another layer of resin. If you or someone in your family participates in sports, this is a great way to make some personalized pieces that are not very expensive. These were made for my daughter's volleyball team. We found these inexpensive charms, flipped them over, filled the background with glitter mixed in resin in her team color, and then added the stickers with a dome layer on top. These make wonderful keepsakes. They can be charms or worn as jewelry. These Halloween pieces are really fun too. In this piece, we mounted our dichroish film with some graphics on top and then the letters applied. And then we domed the whole thing with brilliant resin. And this is sort of a wearable scrapbook. This is my daughter every year on Halloween as she was growing up. And on the back, I used a spiderweb graphic and I just used stickers to indicate her age. You can also make some more elegant looking pieces using more sophisticated graphics or type. I'll demonstrate these techniques on these two pieces. This photo we've reduced using our Little Windows photo cropping software. This 1-inch square with the rounded corners is free at little-windows.com, and you can crop to either a square or a diamond shape and see how that cropper works. If you like it, we also have cropper shapes available for all of our medium and small size molds. We also have paper punches to fit our small, medium, and hearts molds to very easily punch out shapes that will fit in those molds or that can be used on the doming tray. I'm going to demonstrate two techniques, working in a mold and then also working on the doming tray. I've already created this thin layer of resin with glitter in it as the background for this piece, which will be an ornament. Now I'll just cut out the silhouette. For this piece, I'm going to use the red letters to spell out Tyler's name on top. So what I want to do is create some dimension. So I will embed this cut photo in a layer of resin, let that set, and then apply my stickers for the top layer. In this piece, it's going to be a front and a back keychain. So what I'll do is put Jack's name right on the back. I'm using Little Windows Brilliant Resin for all of these projects. It's the safest epoxy you'll find. It's super clear. It's a very, very high quality resin. It comes in a variety of sizes from sample size to very large containers. It has a 2-to-1 mix ratio, so you can make any batch size you'd like. Just be sure that you're mixing 2 parts A to 1 part B. If your resin seems thick at all, just make sure to warm it a little bit before blending with your part B. Make sure to stir the sides and get that little pointy tip down around the bottom ring of your cup. You want to make sure that all of the part A and part B are blended together. That'll prevent sticky spots. I've mixed this for 2.5 minutes. Now we want to let it rest in the mixing cup for 5 more minutes so that it can fully blend and combine and so that the bubbles can rise and pop before we pour this into our projects. When you're working with photographs or anything that's flat, you want to pour the resin into the mold first. And then add the photograph. That way you won't get air pockets trapped underneath. So we'll let this rest and come back in about 10 minutes to pop any bubbles that might come up. I'm using our mini doming tray that comes with our starter kit, but you can also use our small doming tray or the large silicone doming tray that we offer. They all work the same way. You're going to start in the middle and carefully pour a small puddle and that will just flow to the edges. We'll let this piece set up for at least 12 hours, at which time we'll be able to flip it and dome the backside as well. These pieces have set up, so let's add our stickers. First, to remove your cast piece from the molds, hold the sides, gently twist back and forth until you see the sides release. Turn it over on your table, tap. This piece fell right out. You may need to tap the back to get that to come out. If the edges are not completely smooth, you can trim those with scissors. This is going to say Tyler. So what we'll do is I'm going to start from the middle again. So T-Y-L would be the middle letter. And you may want to use tweezers for this. Now we have to protect these stickers, so you want to dome up with another layer of resin. And I'll place this piece on my silicone doming tray to do that. This double-sided piece is ready to flip. Now, if your resin is soft at all, you'll want to protect it from the little fingers on your tray. You can use a piece of wax paper or freezer paper. Just put that down before you flip your piece over to make sure that the little fingers don't dent the front side. I've mixed a batch of Brilliant Resin, so now I'm just going to pour this. You don't want to pour from a height because you can get air trapped underneath the resin, so get as close to your project as you can as you add resin. Make sure before you pour that your surface is level. For the smaller pieces, you can either apply the resin with your mixing wand or form a spout and pour a small puddle just in the center, about the size of a quarter. And that will flow to the edges and dome nicely. Little Window's Brilliant Resin is perfect for doming, casting, layering, embedding, even glazing your pieces. Wait about 30 seconds, and if the resin doesn't flow to the edge, just carefully pull it to the corners. Another way to add letters or numbers or graphics or whatever you want to your resin pieces is with rubdown transfers. And these are sort of a dry ink that's printed on easy release sheets. So literally you just rub it down onto the surface. These are typically made for papers and other surfaces, but you can rub them down between layers of resin. Either with a background. This piece was cast in our medium circles mold and just has resin with a bit of glow in the dark powder mixed in. And this is a clear piece where I just rubbed the letter on between layers of resin. I'm going to do a combination of a name and a graphic. I'm going to use a small crown here. Comes with a protective backing. So you'll peel that off. There's an adhesive on the back of this, so don't touch that before you apply it to your surface. Figure out where you'd like it to be, and then press it down in place. You can sometimes use your fingernail even to transfer this to your piece, or a popsicle stick, or your mixing wand that comes with the resin. This is especially handy for getting into details. I'm going to place a name under here. I'm going to put Kira. Let's start with the middle of that name. Lift it away gently so that you can put it back down in case you miss part of the letter. So we've got our name. Oh, we got a little bit of extra transfer up here, so we'll just take that off. This is not terribly durable at this point, so just be gentle with this until you have your top layer of resin in place. You can also add rubdown transfers to photographs. This again was a photograph printed on the Little Windows special photo paper. So I'm just going to come in and put the family initial right here in the center. Another really fun thing to play with is alphabet beads. These can be arranged as single letters, spelling out a name, or a saying, anything that you want. You can get these at your local craft shop. These are some really beautiful pieces that were made for snap charms, but you can also use these and embed them right into the resin. Here's some examples of projects I've made using the alphabet beads. In this one, I've backed the beads with some colored sprinkles. This one is backed by our resin color film. My plan is to place these letter beads in here, and I know this surface isn't flat. I'll put a piece of thin wire through the letters to hold them together. So I'll pour just a thin layer of resin here. With Brilliant Resin, you have plenty of time to move these around and position them just the way you like. I've got some extra resin, so I'm going to use my medium silicone mold to create a piece with some leftover wire and a little charm. Because the molds have a mirror finish, your piece is going to come out super shiny. And the color and texture of the wire will be reflected up and around the edges. Old gift cards work really beautifully in resin. They're printed on a plastic that won't bleed or run, and the color stays really nice and bright. So you can cut out different elements, single letters, or with all of these different types and colors, you can spell out anything you want, or even arrange them so it looks like a ransom note. Here's a piece I made, cutting up those old gift cards and credit cards. I painted the back of my bezel with nail polish, and when it was tacky, I inserted the letters to hold them in place. You can also use things like postcards and greeting cards. All of these little bits and pieces can be used together or separately in your resin projects. You can also use different kinds of pens and paints and polishes with resin. I don't recommend using Sharpie though, and I'll show you why here. We'll do a little test. First of all, it doesn't really give you an opaque look. It tends to bead up a little bit. And then when you layer it in the resin, it can also bleed. You can use paint pens too. Just make sure to let them dry completely. They're a little harder to control. It's hard to get fine detail with a paint pen. Things that work really well are nail polishes and acrylic paints. I really like these decorative nail art pens. They usually come with a brush and a little tiny pointy tip that's for making details. So this is a really nice way to customize too. You can draw right on your piece. It makes very fine lines. It's very easy to control. You can also draw directly onto your photograph. This is a nail polish pen that I found at the drugstore, and it works really well. You may remember this from some of our other videos, but this is such a fine tip, and it has great application. So you can do all kinds of really fun details with this. You can just draw right onto your resin pieces, and then go over them to thicken them up. This is a piece I cut out from a greeting card, and you can see it's got some embossing on here, a little bit of metallic foil stamping and some glitter. So I thought that would be a beautiful base to make a gift. This can be made into a necklace or a tag or a magnet, whatever you'd like. Our creative friend Kim asked us if you can use jelly roll pens with the resin, and I'm happy to say, yes, you can. And it's beautiful. These are some little tests that I did. I was using the jelly roll ice cream smooth jelly pens. So let me just show you how those work. Again, all of the photos we're working with are printed on our Little Windows special photo paper, so we don't have to seal these in any way before we put them in the resin. So you can play around to see what colors show up best on the photos that you're working with. But I'm just gonna play around here a little bit. So we've got some different colors here of the jelly roll paints, and we'll see how that turns out when we got resin on it. I'm going to be working on a lot of pieces at the same time, so I'm just going to move these around a little bit. If at all possible, don't do this. It just increases the risk that something's going to go wrong. Your resin overflows, or your pieces stick together, or something else gets stuck inside them. Before you pour your resin, make sure that your projects fit underneath whatever dust cover you'll be using. I've mixed up a new batch of Brilliant Resin. You want to skim the top to make sure to remove any fluff that settled on there and any remaining bubbles. Pour the resin in the center of your project and let that flow to the edges. You can also use your mixing wand to pull the resin to the edge. That way you don't risk over pouring. When you have larger pieces, you may also want to put a stiffener on the back of your photo. That way they won't bend or warp as they're setting. You can also make some really cool pieces drying with stickles. Stickles is a kind of glitter glue that's used mostly in scrapbookings, and I love it because it's got super fine glitter and it gives you a nice sort of solid line of glitter color. Let me show you how these turn out, and you can see why we like these more than any other kind of glitter glue. So you can see that the glitter is very evenly distributed. You get a solid line instead of a bunch of clear and then glitter all clumped up. The warning with stickles is make sure that you let it cure for at least 24 hours after applying, because it does take that long for the water-based glue to evaporate so that it doesn't interact with your resin. This is another really fun way that you can use stickers along with alcohol inks to create some monogram type pieces. So let me show you how this works. I've got these pieces already cast in our resin. This one is just for this example. This was actually made in our silicone cabochons mold, and then this one in our medium circle mold. And I'm just gonna use these because I happen to have them around, but you can do this on any shape. You can even do this with pieces that are already colored in some way. And so all I'm gonna do is put a few drops of this blue color on here, and we'll do the same thing down here. We're gonna let it drip right up to the sticker edge and around. Let's get a little bit more because we want full coverage on here. And don't let it run over the side. If it does, just wipe it back off of the resin. There we go. So again, on this one, put a little bit more at the bottom here. The alcohol ink dries pretty quickly. I'm going to add some green. I think it looks like the blue's gonna stand out a little better. So let me come back in here, touch this up with a little bit more blue. And then you can use a toothpick or your mixing wand to move it around a little bit more. I'm just gonna pull this one up so we have complete coverage here, and then bring a little bit of the blue up inside this O. All right, so we're gonna let these dry completely and then peel the stickers off to see what we've got underneath. I have one more experiment I'm gonna try. This is on a piece of cast resin that I made by mixing our white resin colorant in with our Brilliant Resin. And it makes these solid white pieces, which is great for a backing or on its own. Instead of dripping the alcohol ink on this way, I'm going to apply it to from a paper towel and just dab it around the shape. So you want to make sure the ink gets right up to the edges of the shape without saturating it quite as much as the other ones are. This is going to give a much softer color. So again, we'll let this dry and see how it turns out. Make sure to dab the edges as well to get. So we're ready to peel the stickers off. Be careful not to scratch off the alcohol ink. Now again, we need to add another layer of resin to protect this alcohol ink because it can scratch off. Get some help from my tweezers here. You can use your tweezers to gently scrape off any ink that got underneath the sticker. I'm going to use this section to hold my cabochon straight while I add my top layer of resin. That looks pretty interesting. If you wanted to add a detail outline to emphasize the letter, you can certainly do that. For more project ideas and tips for success, please subscribe and be sure to visit our Project Center at little-windows.com.